Okay, but you can see that the setting everything manually is not so convenient. Then how to do this? I here reset with this button my clock configuration to have the default settings. You can see everything is by default 60 MHz. This is the default settings of the microcontroller after reset. But if I'm too lazy to configure everything, I can put here the value and he try for me to calculate the frequency. Now he asking if he can change the clock source because we cannot use for the 84 the HSE as a clock source. Then we click here and he automatically configure the 84 megahertz. You can always write the values inside this blue boxes which are around it. I can reset it again to show you that is really working. I can here type the 42, for example. Again, he asking me to change the clock source. Then I can allow him this feature and it's working. Okay. Last part to mention. Maybe you can see that not all the functionalities are available, like here the second PLL, which belongs to the I2S. In case that we enable the I2S, again in the pinout, if I point here my mouse, you can see the advice to enable the I2S. Then if I go to the pinout, I here enable the I2S. Yes, here, for example, into full duplex, you can see it's now enabled. Then this is the mystery of the gray unused functions. Then you need only the enable this functionality in the pinout tab. And also this is the second part, the MCOs. Here are not only inputs, which can be used to clock the microcontroller, but also you have mainly one or two outputs, depends on the type of the microcontroller and the size of your package, which can be used. It's called the MCO 1 or 2. And in case, again, you want to enable these MCOs, you need to enable them in the IP, in the pinout. Then we go to the pinout. He advises us to go into RCC and here enable the master clock output 1 or 2. I can both. He also reserves for me the pins. And now you can see the multiplexer is active. I can select the output. I directly see the frequency which I have. I can divide also the output. And this allow me to clock some internal circuits. Again, for the low speed clock, you can see it again, they are not connected to any periphery. One is the independent watchdog, second part is the real-time clock. In case that I want to change here this multiplexer, I need to enable the real-time clock. I go to the pinout. I here in the real-time clock, I, for example, enable the periodic wake-up system. And I can also enable here the independent watchdog. And you can see now I can set the clock source for the real-time clocks. And also the independent watchdog have valid clocks. Okay, only last feature which I forget to mention on this microcontroller. In case that you're using the external high speed clocks, here I change it to the external high speed for the core or for the PLL. Okay, now I'm using 25 MHz 25 megahertz high speed external oscillator for my core. And you can see that here is available the button. It's called the clock security system. It's used in case that a zero clock source is are the external clock circuit, at least the crystal or the oscillator or the any external frequency, and it's clock source for your PLL or directly for the core. Because in case that the external clock source will fail, the microcontroller will be blocked. For this is here the clock security system, which can be enabled. And in case that this external clock will fail, the microcontroller will automatically switch to the internal clock source, to the HSE, automatically. And the user is notified with the interrupt. That is something wrong, you lose the external clocks, then you can switch into emergency mode, for example. Okay. Definitely, in case you have the different microcontroller type, not the F401 like me, the clock tree will be a little bit different, but the basic clock tree is still very similar. We still have always the PLL, always the system multiplexer, always the AHB Pascales, APB Pascales. It's always the same. We only have the multiple outputs from the PLLs. We have more PLLs, but the basic is the same. PLL can multiply the frequency and also divide the frequency. We have the dividers. We have the multiplexers, which selecting the clock source. In case the functionality is gray, point there with the mouse, and the CubeMX will try to advise you what is wrong, what is necessary to enable. In case that you are not happy with your configuration, you can here click on the button to reset the clock configuration. Or here in the clock configuration is to reset. Or here is the button to resolve the issues. In case that is something wrong, you here can click to the resolve the issues, and the CubeMX will try for you resolve all the issues. The last part, which can be here mentioned, in case you want to some specific configuration, which is related to the many dividers and multiplexers in the row, for example, for this timer, I want to have the specific frequency, for example, 20 megahertz. Okay. E for me now configure everything, but I want here to have the different frequency, for example, 40, because I can. Then here I can click with the right button, and I here set the lock. This means that now the CubeMX, if we reconfigure the frequency, he will try here keep always the 20 megahertz. You can see now I can try to put here the 40. He reconfigure everything, but here it's always the 20. And I think he never allow me here put the 30. He will try. He will try all the possibilities, if it's possible to set this frequency or not. If not, he will notify us, or he will advise us the closest frequency which is possible. Then we can left him to search all the possibilities. And you can see there is no possible solution. He can also try use the different clock sources. And now he trying to use also the external one, all the possible combination. But I worry that this is impossible configuration, and on the end he will tell us that it's not possible to use the microcontroller in this configuration. On the end, the Cube MX gave us possibility to select for here 20 or 40 MHz. It was only possibility, because the configuration which I put the 30 MHz and 20, it's impossible. And everything is okay.